総理大臣の職を辞することといたします。
Per year, Japanese workers left 10 of those days unused, topping every other country in the survey. You don't have to be in the confines of corporate walls to feel the impact of its work culture.
By social responsibility instead of harsh penalties, so far Japan seems to have dodged the worst of the pandemic. Even with a population three times Canada's, the death toll is less than an eighth.
2020 has been such a challenging year, to say the least. It's thrown many curveballs our way, and one of the most recent ones surprised world leaders across the globe. Late in August, Japan's Prime Minister Shinzo Abe announced that he has decided to step down as Japan's Prime Minister, just a mere 4 days after setting a record for having the longest continuous run as a leader of Japan. In the midst of a global pandemic, this new event thrusts the country into further uncertainty over the future.With almost 8 years of leadership, Prime Minister Abe was able to keep the nation in political stability. What will happen to Japan now? What is going to happen to the economy now that a new leader is projected to come into the picture? That's exactly what we're going to be talking about today on Shinzo Abe's resignation and its effect on the markets. This is Business Explained. To learn more all about things money, get educated about how to do business, become business savvy, and enjoy more videos like these, subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell, and may you be granted with many, many sweet returns. Before we dig into his resignation and repercussions, let's talk about who Shinzo Abe is.Shinzo Abe was born on the 21st of September 1954 in Tokyo to a political family. His family was influential and prominent, with his grandfather, Nobusuke Kishi, being dubbed as the economic king of China, Korea, and a Japanese puppet state in northern China called Manchukuo. This provided Abe the platform he needed to pursue his own political career.Nobusuke Kishi served as Japan's prime minister from 1957 to 1960, and he was supposed to be on trial for being a war criminal after the war. However, things changed when policy shifted and Japan became more anti-communist. Nobusuke Kishi was let go and went on to create the Japan Democratic Party. This is what caused Shinzo Abe to favor conservatism. People used to refer to his grandfather as a war criminal.And this repelled Shinzo Abe from democratic views. In 1933, Shinzo Abe was elected as part of the House of Representatives and went on to be Chief Cabinet Secretary in 2005. He then replaced Junichiro Koizumi as LDP President in September 2006. At age 52, he became Japan's youngest post-war Prime Minister. However, the recent news of his resignation isn't the first one he's made during his political career. After his first year in the office as Prime Minister, Shinzo Abe announced his resignation. Why? Well, Abe cited ulcerative colitis as a reason, a disease that has afflicted him since he was a teenager. Yasuo Fukuda replaced Abe. He and the four others became Prime Minister, but they were all unable to last more than 16 months as Prime Minister.Abe reportedly recovered from his illness and returned as Prime Minister of Japan. He became the first Prime Minister to do so since Shigeru Yoshida in 1948. He continued to get re-elected in 2014 and 2017 as well. However, recently, Abe once again announced his resignation as Prime Minister, citing the return of his ulcerative colitis. According to Abe, his poor health prevents him from putting all his focus on governing Japan, especially through the coronavirus pandemic that has been prevalent in most countries across the globe for the majority of 2020. Shinzo Abe was able to see the country through countless disasters, but he was unable to do three things during his time as Japan's Prime Minister.Revise the pacifist constitution that was brought about by the United States after the Second World War, regain the contested islands from Russia and sign a peace treaty with the region, and safely bring back Japanese citizens who were kidnapped by North Korea some years back. However, he wants to ensure that the position of Prime Minister would go to someone who can pour all of his time and energy into tackling the pandemic and the other challenges that come with being Prime Minister. So what will Shinzo Abe's resignation do to the markets? Before we delve into that, let's take a look at this thing called Abenomics. What is Abenomics?Abenomics refers to economic policies of Shinzo Abe. In the same way that Ronald Reagan had his Reaganomics to refer to his economic policies, Shinzo Abe has his Abenomics. So what economy policies does Abe have in his Abenomics? Abenomics involves boosting the money supply of the nation, increasing government spending, and creating reforms that maintain the competitiveness of the Japanese economy. Prior to Shinzo Abe's second term, Japan's economy had been considered stagnant. He decided to change that by inciting three pillars that would ideally boost the economy. These three pillars are as follows. The first is to print additional currency to put into the market, which would create inflation. It would also make Japanese exports appear more attractive. Next would be how government spending would increase to create short-term growth. It would also create a budget surplus as time passes. The last pillar is to create reforms that would make Japanese industries more competitive. It allows for easier hiring of non-locals, liberalizing the health sector, and putting in policies that would help both the foreign and local businesses flourish. This is how Japan would use free trade to be more competitive in the world market. While Shinzo Abe was seated as Prime Minister, this is how the Japanese economy worked. What was the effect of these three pillars on the Japanese economy? Well, as of July 2020, Japan only has 2.90% unemployment, and its economy is continually and steadily growing. Now, what would Shinzo Abe's resignation mean? Will that mean that Abenomics will come to an end? Well, some analysts are suggesting that it would not. His resignation came as a surprise, and Abe has said that he would step down as soon as the Liberal Democratic Party has found someone to take his place. How did investors react to the news? Well, Japan's stock market fell, and the Nikkei 225 index ended up closing down at 1.4%, and the yen rose in value against the dollar. According to Shinzo Abe, his implemented economic policies based on Abenomics were able to end Japan's deflation period and increase the amount of jobs available to Japanese citizens. And even with the Prime Minister's resignation announcement, it doesn't look like the style of economics would change. Analysts are expecting that the Abenomics would continue within Japan. Japanese bonds have weakened by a bit, and analysts suggest that this may continue until they are able to officially appoint a new prime minister in Abe's place. They also project that the Nikkei 225 would go up by a little bit. While Abenomics may not have been the perfect economic solution and was not able to achieve every single one of its goals, it has still kept Japan relatively stable economically. Although there are certainties yet on the type of policies a new prime minister would put in place, it is most likely that they would follow the same economic policies that Shinzo Abe put into place. Strategists suggest that there would be two things the market would be focusing on in the short run. It is highly likely that corporate governance reforms would continue, and the Bank of Japan may have a chance of leadership. Abe was not the sole driving factor of the stability in Japan's economy, so his departure would not make as big of a difference as one would initially think. What are your thoughts on Shinzo Abe's resignation? Do you think it will have more of an impact on the market than analysts are suggesting? Let me know what you think and write it down in the comments section below. I'll be responding to all of you who comment within the first hour. If this video intrigued you, why not check out my other video called Top Investing Mistakes? What if I told you there was a way to make your money grow passively? You just put it somewhere and it grows and gives you the returns you want after a while? You can do that by investing. Hold on, I know you might be ready to dive in, and I know how exciting it is to imagine the rewards you're hoping for. But before you buy in, make sure you're aware of the most common mistakes investors make. Learn all about them through watching Top Investing Mistakes. Stay tuned, stay educated.